All right, how do you get a partner, right? This is something that we constantly are encouraging people to do. This has been the key for us as far as getting out of the bullshit we were always stuck in. So without having a partner, from what we see and understand from psychology, you are just going to go in a circle in life. It's going to be the same old problems, the same old blame, the same old victimization, struggling with the same crap every year. That's what life is going to be like without a partner. Why? Because what you're really good at in life, your amazing savior functions and your awesome personality type, comes at a cost, because that means that you're not good naturally at the opposites of that. And our brains are seemingly wired to hide that reality from us. So you're never going to accidentally, or not never, it's going to take a lot of years until you finally have enough times around the planet to go, huh, these common patterns in my relationship problems are actually coming from me. A lot of people do kind of figure that out once they hit 50 and beyond, right? Midlife crisis, regret, etc. Having a partner, having a team, having somebody who's respectfully able to smack you in the side of the head and say, hey, Dick, you are going the wrong way. I know you are pumped up with dopamine, feeling like you're enlightened and you're on the path, but you're not. A partner is going to help you minimize those detours and crashes in life. So how do you find a partner? How do you find a partner as far as a life partner, somebody you can marry? How do you find a good friend? How do you find an objective personality typing study partner? And how do you find a partner in business, whether you're working at a job or creating your own thing? So what we have found, we kind of got this from watching others, the silly saying of you got to give to get, you know, reciprocity. God damn it. That stuff is very true. So here's just a practical set of tips that I've used over the years, I'd say over the past 10 years. And this is something that has worked 100% of the time for me. Now, again, dependent upon how much work and effort I put into it. Sometimes I'd have to work on this for quite a while before to get a return, but this is something that does work no matter what. So here's an example. Today, when you have things like Instagram, you can type in search tags of things that you're interested in. Say you're interested in photography or computer programming or gaming, just any stupid thing. You go into Instagram and you're just searching the hashtags of people that are talking about that topic. And then you go and you find the desperate business owners. And you're gonna know them when you see them, because they're gonna have these kind of copy and paste pictures, and they're trying to offer sales, struggling to get their sandwich shop or their print shop or their website up and running, and it's just a small team, and they're in a desperate spot, right? And so you take some time out of your week that you kind of devote it to almost like missionary time. So this is going to be a write-off. Call this like a tax write-off to yourself. And what you do is you contact these people out there, and there's millions of them, and you say, you know, hey, Johnny, I saw your website and I'm really interested in what you're doing, and I noticed that your code was off a little here, or your pictures look like they're stolen from BitTorrent, so I made you an image that I thought you'd like. Or I did this for you, I did that for you. Or maybe you're writing them some advice or whatever the hell it is that you can give. And then that's it. You send it to them, you shut up, you don't ask for anything in return. Literally, depending on how well you do it, and this takes time to get good at this, right? Very quickly, 1 out of 4, maybe 1 out of 5, people are gonna write you back and go, wow, thanks a lot, that was really helpful, that was really interesting, and now you're striking up a conversation. Same idea with dating. You're not running up to the person and saying, hey, let's take this relationship to the next step. You wanna give that person a nice time, a nice experience. Give, asking and accepting nothing in return, even though the reality is you're hurting, you're in a desperate spot, you need, right? All you want to do is grab them around the neck and drown them and say, help me, love me, be my friend, give me a job, right? That's all you want to do, because that's the reality of the situation you're in, right? I get it. You got to hold that off, pretend like you got it all together, act like you're full and abundant, and give to others without any expectation, and they will have to respond, because they're like, what the hell is this? Somebody coming to me, actually helping, actually giving? I haven't seen anybody do that lately. And now you're going to have yourself a friend.